Folge Werkwegsfolge.
Welcome to another edition of Don Alphin on Fishing. It's 21st of December, Flaming Gorge. We don't have any inkling of ice down here. I'm just at Swim Beach right now, and I just feel really confident that we're going to be able to catch a fish or two this afternoon. It's about 2:30 in the afternoon. And no wind, and it's shirt sleeve weather, kind of, so to speak. So stay tuned. Hopefully I'll be able to put a fish or two in the boat and tell you a little bit about what I'm doing. Obviously, you can tell because I'm slow trolling that I'm probably using my glide baits, which you'd be absolutely right. So thanks for watching. Stay tuned. Okay, so what I'm doing is I've got two glide baits out. Now, you notice if you watch any of my glide bait videos that I've done in the spring and in the early summer, you'll know that I love to cast and retrieve these things. But today I just did not want to bother with putting them on either a spin cast rod or a reel or my bait casters that I usually use for bass fishing, and I just decided to go out and put my trolling rods out. So I'm actually slow trolling. I'm actually going 1.4 miles an hour, and I'm just working the shallows. And by shallows, I'm talking anywhere less than 30 feet, and just looking at my finder. I've got one finder that's got a map on it, so I can track my route, and then I've got another finder that's just set up with the transducer up in the front of my boat so that I can see if there are any fish that you can see shallow, and that's basically what I'm up to. So last time I came out and did this in this particular area, had several bites, had a friend of mine with me, but we never did get a hook set. So I'm hoping that now we got back from Mexico and we're just amazed at how beautiful the weather's been as far as since we were back. But we're calm conditions, and these fish should be coming up and biting. So, but that's all I'm doing. So I've got I'm out at least 100 feet behind the boat, and we're just hoping that we can get a fish going. Okay, guys, I'm starting to see a few marks on the finder. I'm in 15 feet of water, and these marks, I don't know whether you can see it here, but I'm gonna try to show you these marks right here. Definitely fish, and there's four or five of them right there together, hoping that one of them will decide to come up and bite. They're not necessarily looking like they're huge fish, but they're certainly capable of taking these glide baits. So that's I'm just trying to keep myself anywhere between 0 and 30 feet, actually 10 and 30 feet. I don't want to be at 0, of course, but that's what we're doing, hopefully get a nice fish to go. Well, been fishing with the glide baits, and this is now the second fish that I've caught. First one I didn't even get a chance at. Oh my gosh, this baby's way out there. I don't know whether you can see it, but it's way out there, and it is taking line, screaming line. This is a dandy fish. I'd sure like to get it in. It's the 21st day of December on Flaming Gorge. I happen to be in Swim Beach right now, but what a beautiful hit that was. And that fish just absolutely snarfed it. So we're hoping to get this one in. I had a net screw up the last time with the other one that I just had on 10 minutes ago. So We'll see if I can't get a little bit better situation going here. It's not that big. It's a dandy though. I'll tell you what, you can see that thing. It just hit me like a ton of bricks, that fish. Oh, look at that thing go. Wow. What a nice fish. He took the white. Boy, he really is. Now he knows he's hooked, man. I had him almost in there and thought I could go grab the net and get him going, but now it's a fighter. Which we certainly love. Oh, it's a dandy fish. He gets bigger the closer he gets in. Yeah, he's not hooked very well, actually. So I might lose him right here at the boat if I don't play him right. Wow, still taking line. Come on, baby. Don't get in the trolling motor now. After all that. Yeah, he's right. Well hooked. Now I can see he's on there. Oh, he was in the net. He doesn't want to see that net again. Oh, what a nice fish. This is a Christmas fish, I'll tell you that much right now. This is a Christmas fish. He just does not want, she does not want to give up. Yeah, I got her. Oh my goodness, what a beautiful, beautiful fish. That baby is all over it. I'm gonna go ahead and take care of her, measure her, and I don't think I'm gonna weigh her, but we'll get that done and get her back in the water for sure. Well, I wanted to film the release on that fish, but it just took off like a bat out of Hades. So anyway, 34 inches, about 19 and a half inches around. I'll have to go do the math and see what that was, but I didn't actually put it on the scale. So what a great fish. Well, what a gorgeous afternoon. We're just moving in and out of the water column, this back and forth kind of serpentining all the way around, and trying to give as many looks as we can. And when I'm doing this slow troll, I really do like to move in and move out and change the positioning of the bait. I learned when I'm fishing the lake trolls, Colton Christensen's Lakeshore Tackles lake trolls, I've noticed that there are times when I can I'll have a big old fish following that the lake troll, and with my Garmin LiveScope I can see the actual string behind the boat, so I know that this is happening. I'm watching the same fish literally chase that string of blades many times, several hundred yards before they come up and actually take it. So I'm convinced that anything you can do to change up what you're doing just a little tiny bit might be whatever makes that fish decide to come up and eat, because I'm certain that fish are following these baits when they're in the water. It's just exactly what they eat. They look exactly like what they eat. So I'm sure there are fish following, but they don't necessarily take. And so I think by making a jog one way or the other, makes that bait do something just a little bit different. And maybe it's the fight or flight kind of situation where the fish thinks that the bait fish is headed out and going somewhere else, and they decide to pounce at that particular point. So that's why I don't just go in a straight line. I try to move around as I can. I'm now into 21 feet of water, so I'm going to try to go in shallower and see if I can't get a real good look at anywhere between, at this point, 10 and 21 feet. Well, thanks for watching this small episode of Don Olphin on Fishing. I've only been out for an hour in this particular spot. I came out earlier today and fished, but this is only been an hour since I've switched back to my glide baits, and was able to hook two fish and land one, as you could see the one that I landed, and 34 incher, 19 and a half inch girth, a beautiful fish, and it really fought well. I hope the footage works out for it, but thanks for watching. I got a phone call and figured out that I need to be somewhere else right now and not on the water, so I'm gonna have to cut this one short. But as long as we've got no ice out here and we have a nice good day, you can still get out here and catch these fish. They're ready to bite. So thanks again for watching, and have a Merry Christmas.